So the ANTS toolkit, ANT stands for Active Node Transfer System, took a different approach to show the utility of the vision. Since modifying the protocol stack is non-trivial, instead the ANTS toolkit is really an application-level package. And this toolkit is available for the application programmer to say, here is my payload and here is my quality of service constraints. And what the ANTS toolkit does is to create an ANTS header to this payload. So the new payload looks like this, and this is what is called a capsule. And the capsule consists of an ANTS header and the actual payload. And this is what is given to a normal operating system protocol stack. And so this normal operating system protocol stack looks at this as the payload that is being given to it, and it knows the destination address where this has to go, so sticks on the IP header for it. So the new packet that is generated by the protocol stack looks like this. It has the IP header, and the rest of it is payload so long as this protocol stack is concerned. But we know that this payload consists of two parts. One is the normal payload that the application generated, and in addition to that, there is the ANTS header that has been slapped on by the ANTS toolkit. And this is what traverses a network. And when it traverses a network, if a node in the network is a normal node, meaning it is not a smart node, but it is a normal IP router, then it simply uses the IP header to say, well, here is what I have to do in terms of sending the packet to the next hop towards the destination. On the other hand, if a node that receives this packet is an active node, then it can actually process this ANTS header and say, oh, this particular packet needs to be demultiplexed and sent to two different routes, and it might take that intelligent routing decision based on the nature of that node. So that's the idea, that we can push one of the pain points out of the operating system into an ANTS toolkit that lives above the operating system. So that's sort of the ANTS toolkit vision. That's one part. Now the second part is, of course, the fact that the internet may not be open to opening up all the routers to be processing the specialized code that comes in the capsule. So what we do is we keep the active nodes only at the edge of the network. Or in other words, the core IP network is unchanged, and all of the magic happens only at the edge of the network. So once again, if I go back to my example of sending greetings to my siblings, then only the edge nodes have to do the magic in order to take my original message and process the code to deliver it to multiple destinations. So the rest of the network can remain unchanged. So the core of the IP network can be unchanged, and intelligence can be at the edge of the network. So this is sort of allowing, sort of marrying this active network vision with the core IP network being unchanged.